What's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is TDS Darth Wage back at you with another video yet again. And in this video, I have to ask a question yet again. And that question is, why buff Boba Fett? I really need to know this because, okay, with that being said, there's a few things that I do understand about them buffing his health. Yes, he is a glass cannon. Now, yes, he can die very quickly. That is very true. So the health buff, I don't really mind. Now, there is another good thing that they are doing to him, and they are changing his crosshair or his reticle, which is turning it from what it is currently into a dot crosshair. And to me, I think that should have been there from the beginning for the simple fact of how his blaster shoots in Battlefront 2. Now, with that being said, I want to get into what I highly disagree with. And that's for the simple fact is that they are fixing to make it where he can, if he is knocked out of the sky and goes into freefall, he can catch himself midair and keep flying or keep using his jetpack. Go back to using his jetpack while in freefall, which will basically take him out of the freefall and put him back to flying yet again. Now, this I highly disagree with. Now, with that being said, yes, I disagree with it. Now, but with that being said, there is one thing about it that is valid. There is a valid point to look at. Yes, it would be more immersive. It would be more true to the character. That is very true. Now, the issue is not the immersion, but the balance. The balance of the game. I honestly think whenever he gets this for his jetpack, it is going to highly unbalance the game. I mean, you see me right here as Yoda currently, right? This is Boba Fett with what he's capable of doing already. Alright? So keep this in mind. You see me, I'm trying to hit him, and I know some people would probably leave a comment and say, just time his dodges, time his jetpack when he lands. Well, the thing is he can land in anywhere. He can land in some very hard to reach places, if you have not noticed, like Yoda, for example. Even now that his jump height is increased to everybody else's, he is still struggling to go in these places that Boba Fett can go. Now, with that being said, there are counters to him, such as Finn. That's very true. There is Lando with his sharp shot, or whatever it's called, sharp shot, which locks onto a target if they are in the air. So Lando is anti-air, Finn is anti-air, Anakin can pull him out of the sky and put him into the force power combo, and Luke can also push him out of the sky, and Obi-Wan can, if he does his force push correctly, can basically snipe Boba Fett out of the sky with the star card that extends the length of his push. This I agree with. But if they are not in the match, because as you see, I'm here in Hero Showdown, it's actually quite unfair for the simple fact is that he can almost fly indefinitely, and even whenever he does land, he still has one of the best dodges in the game, which prevents him from getting hit, which gives him enough time to get a little boost in his jetpack, long enough for him to get his ability back that gives him infinite jetpack. Now, the way they need to balance this is they need to get rid of the crap where he his ability grants him infinite jetpack for a certain amount of seconds, because this right here is what he's currently getting away with. And there's like characters like Yoda have no way to stop it. Characters like Rey have no way to stop it. None of them have a true there are certain characters that do not have anything that they can do about it. That's what I'm trying to say. And whenever they, you know, whenever you knock him out of the sky with a force power or something like that, that's where you capitalize and punish them for getting knocked out of the sky. Now, with that being said, with the new update that's going to make it where he can just recover and keep flying after getting knocked out of the sky or whatever, if he can catch himself mid-fall. Okay, this is what I'm trying to say. He can catch himself mid-fall, and then there's no way you can punish him. People say use Chewie. Okay, but Chewie currently right now does not stand a very good chance in Heroes versus Villains. I mean, don't get me wrong. In the right hands, I'm sure he's probably like some kind of god. He does have good damage, but he's got a slow fire rate. And honestly, Chewie doesn't really stand up by himself, is what I'm trying to say. So really, it's like you're kind of sacrificing a more true potential just to defeat one character when you have to think about multiple characters that you will be facing, such as Vader and Maul and Kylo and Dooku and Grievous and Iden and, you know, so on. That's what I'm trying to say. There are counters to him. That's why I'm saying, yes, I can agree with the health buff, and I can agree with the crosshair change. But I disagree with him being a... If you're going to make it where he can, you know, recover mid-air, you better get rid of the, you know, him having infinite jetpack while his... I think it's called Bounty Hunter or something like that. His middle ability, or... You know the ability I'm talking about that gives him infinite jetpack. Basically, if they're going to make it where he can catch himself in midair and just keep on flying, he should not be able to abuse that, you know, indefinitely. He should not be able to abuse that to the point that nobody can do anything to get him out of the sky. Yes, Finn is a great character. Finn will be getting a damage buff. And that's the thing, is Boba Fett's getting a health buff and Finn's getting a damage buff. Alright, so you have to take those into account, and then you have to do the comparison of who's going to be more effective. That's all I'm trying to say, is I think this is highly going to unbalance the game and make Boba Fett a little too fucking strong. I mean, yeah, we got Anakin. I'm just saying, in my own personal opinion, I think Boba Fett is fixing to get an unnecessary buff. Well, certain buffs are necessary, but I think the jetpack being able to recover mid-fall is going to be ridiculous. But anyway, that's going to be all for this video. If you like the video, then please give me a like, comment, subscribe, and share.